So, hello, welcome to a new video. And we are now in request number 2 for the discussion list for the Sony software team. And again, we are still at the easy ones. You will find in the description the list of the Google Doc that we are making on Facebook and also YouTube. And we slowly are going from easy fixes to more complex fixes. But this is the second one we want them to look at. Let me scroll to the correct one. So we did one yesterday, we now are in request number 2. And request number 2 is basically about the way that sometimes toggles work. So a good example, and we'll try to show you on the camera later on, is that in some modes, it actually does what you expect. So for example, if you want to go from APS-C mode to full frame mode, which is very handy to put on your camera on the C3 button. So if you are filming, you just press this button and it will go from full frame to a APS-C mode, which is extremely, extremely handy. That works. If you go into the rating app, which I'm also using the same button for, that works even better because depending on how much options you set, it actually will, if only 2 options are left, it will start toggling, if that makes sense. So if you have 3 or 4 options, again, I will show it, it will not toggle, but the moment you only have 2 options left, it will actually start toggling. But then in other places, it doesn't. The one that bothers me the most, because I think it would be the most useful for most people, is actually the silent shooting button. So I will show you how in 3 different modes I'm using the same button, the C3 button in this case, and how is it this affects that they are not solving this problem. So like I said, in sometimes it behaves as you expect and sometimes it doesn't. So the simple fix, which I also outlined here, is just to fix the one for silent shooting. That makes sense because it's a very obvious one. The better fix and is going through the whole interface a little bit and see what other options are actually a toggle or could be a toggle, I guess. That makes more sense. Sometimes because there are only 2 options, right? Turning something on and something off. Sometimes simply because if you can set up multiple options, then if you only have 2 options left, then you could make it a toggle. So that's basically a firmware request number 2, and I think very doable. So let me show it in practice, and then, that makes sense, I hope. So let's switch to that one. Again, you can find the Google Doc in the YouTube video or in the files area on the Facebook group. So let's show what I mean so it becomes more clear. I will close my laptop a tiny bit, change the light. Tiny bit on me, but that's okay. So hopefully this will all work because we are of course connected over the, and I just ran out of battery, so that's not too smart. I guess what we could do is I will just get up in my normal misbehaving self and replace the battery and then come back, and while we are getting the battery, I will still talk to you. So this, I think, is a good example again, while I'm getting a battery. That's why, by the way, I have a wireless microphone on all the time. I know myself a little bit, and what can I say? Having a wireless microphone means that I don't have to that I take the whole setup with me. So, went to the other room, got a battery. Let's put it in there. Which I guess showcases that you can indeed replace the battery in the new small rig set. Even with my weird ass fixes. I should have checked this. Oh well. Am I the only one that is still a little bit sort of bothered by the fact that you have to do the battery the other way around? between the A7 series and the A6000 series. Maybe it's just me. Hopefully this one is charged. So, yeah, okay, welcome back. It turned the back screen off again, but hopefully we do have a finder. Let's see if that is true. Yeah, there it is. So a good example is, let me try to, I guess I could use the smaller one for that. So I'm each time using this button, the C3 button, and you can see what the action is on the screen. Let me, hopefully you forgive me, I will get better and better at this, but let me also change quickly the effect that I am using for this, because I think it's probably best if I do it. No. Do not agree. I think the smaller one is still better. So I only have two options. Somebody asked about it. I only have two options, either going full half of the screen or only a quarter of the screen. But I guess you can see that the button over here, the C3 button that I'm using all the time, for the same function. So I'm now still in picture mode. And here's where the problem is. So if I hit the C3 button, which is, of course, my natural tendency would be to hit the button like this, right? And you will see that it then decides to ask me if you want to go to silent mode. And that doesn't make any sense, because of course I can use either the buttons or the front dial, which you can also use, right? The front dial to change it, which is, by the way, is a good sort of option. So if you hit it, you can use the front dial, and then you don't even have to confirm it, by the way. You can just see it works, right? So you press the button, but you still have to do a second action in actually changing the function, and then it goes. Well, in other places, and remember, I'm now in photo mode, right? So in photo mode, I'm using the C3 button for that. But if I go to another mode, so let me go to review mode first, right? So we just do the picture. I go to review mode. Now I've programmed this button as my voting button. So you see, if I hit it, that it will give me the 5-star at the top, and it will remove the 5 stars. Now, I'm not going to show you, but you can set up where somewhere in the menu if you want to allow for 1-star, 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5 stars. I turned all of them up, off, only allow for 5 stars. And then actually what it does, it starts to use this toggle function. You see, just on and just off. So there it works perfectly. Now, if you go into movie mode, I have to stand up a bit, you'll see same thing happening, right? So I'm now in moving mode, and this is a very handy one. But then it actually toggles in the correct way. It does not ask me, same thing as silent shooting. It can only be on and off. But you can see now if I hit the C3 button, it will zoom in and zoom out. So basically go into crop mode and go out of crop mode. Go into crop mode, go out of crop mode, which is what we want, right? So the second request that we are putting out there is basically, please sort of fix this, that with... especially the silent shooting mode, that would be very interesting to do. Another interesting option might actually be to also use the long press in this area, so that if you hold the button, that it actually only does it on the next shot or while you are holding the button. But I would already be very happy with this one. So let's check if we now covered the whole enchilada, if we indeed talked about the request. So the simple fix, just fix it for silent mode. The better fix, make sure that you check the API, or sorry, the menu system, for more places where this could actually be helpful. So that's the second request that we are putting out there, and hopefully this is one that can be used, because I think the reuse, especially of the C3 button, but maybe somebody else wants to use another one, but I use the C3 button in these three different modes, makes it a perfect way for me, at least, to use it as a toggle, And yeah, if you have a toggle that only has two options, but it asks you, do you want to go to the other option? It's kind of, to be fair, kind of silly. And the silent shooting one is probably the one that is bothering me the most. So yeah, see you in the next one. And slowly they will become more and more sort of complex and difficult. And maybe more solutions are possible in these. Please keep sending me both on Facebook with DMs or on comments on the videos, which is, by the way, also a good place to do it on YouTube. I know there's about 10 of them that I still need to check. Yeah, that's what happened because I started asking this about a month ago, and only now I'm sort of getting to the point of making these videos and updating the Google Doc. So see you in the next one, and bye-bye.